And finally you arrive, York.
George is dead. You've got nowhere left to run.
George! Oh, right, George! He was a funny one.
I gave him a toy locket, and he was so impressed.
So moved.
But he wasn't very intelligent. He was born in this town, you see, and it took him too long to discover the Red Sea. Binding down people's rules is a sign of small-mindedness, and that was what George represented in life.
I'm taking Emily.
Oh, but I can't allow that now, can I? York, you left her to me, in my care, remember? I told you to come with us, didn't I?
You must remember that.
But you didn't come. You chose your job over the woman that you love.
Casey, this chit-chat is over.
Over? Indeed it is. My fun with Emily ended just a moment ago.
It was a fantastic moment. Like eating a full-course dinner that ends with the ultimate dessert. I fed her a fake story about my past, and she took in every word.
Cut out your nonsense. I told you, no more talk.
There you go, York. That's right. Feel the hate boiling from the bottom of your stomach. That's what makes little men create such great and amazing history. Just like tiny ants that make giant ant hills. You know, I just had dessert and yet I'm already hungry again. No wonder why I keep failing at keeping a diet.
Kaysen, stop! The next one will pierce you between your eyes.
York!
Emily, it's me. I'm here. Don't worry. Everything will be fine now.
York? Is that you? Oh, thank God. York, I...
Emily, no! That isn't me!
York... York...
Emily! It's okay, Emily. Hurry, come over here. We need to get you to the hospital.
I can't. I can't go to you. I've been soiled.
No, that's not true. You have a heart that can't be soiled. No matter what happens to your body, you are still yourself.
York, I...
Oh, didn't I tell you? Getting these saplings to sprout requires a certain technique. Artistic, isn't it? It's like a surrealistic painting.
York.
Emily?
Let me die. Please. York.
Zach, what should I do?